Hi everyone, I am Mohammed Almutairi. My topic is green synthesized zinc oxide nanoparticles and their antibacterial activity. First of all, what's green synthesized nanoparticles? Green synthesized nanoparticles are a combination of blends of their or their metabolites with inorganic chemical in order to reduce the toxicity. And nanoparticles are particles, their size range between 1 to 100 nanometer in diameter. This technology has been emerged as an important modern area of research because surface ratio to volume ratio, which causes them to become reactive to some other molecules. The most synthesized metal is sulfur, gold, zinc, and zinc oxide and titanium. Our metal is zinc oxide, which uses in some products such as cosmetic and sunscreen cream. It's thought that the blend may enhance nanoparticles functions, or the reverse, nanoparticles may enhance blend function. In this case, zinc oxide nanoparticles may enhance nanoparticles. However, green synthesize depend on some factors, which are temperature, solvent, pressure, and pH, whereas from blend, it depend on phytochemicals such as flavonoids, phenols, or other active chemicals. Potential basic applications from green synthesis nanoparticles are reduction of hazard waste, designing of safer chemical, and more importantly, alternative to antibiotic resistant and antibiotic and preservatives. The antimicrobial activity of nanoparticles depend on size of particles because surface ratio to volume ratio at a critical point, also the functional group of plants exposed on nanoparticles. The aim of my study are evaluating the green synthesized zinc oxide nanoparticles antibacterial activities against E. coli 0157, H7 Sakai, which is a common foodborne pathogen, as well Bacillus cereus R3054, also foodborne pathogen and spores forming, and the marine bacteria Alphabriophilus tuensis strains A4, A9, A15, A21, A33, and A37, which are very drug resistant. Also, it grows in farm Atlantic salmon to a high level, and it's thought to potentially cause dysbiosis in the gut of salmon during the summer. The second aim of the study is the reduction of zinc salt into zinc oxide using Tasmanian lanceolate and Quinsia ambigua leaf extract. These plants are industrially used for essential oil extract. And actually, there is no studies have investigated this plant in terms of synthesized zinc oxide nanoparticles. Now, let's see how we made it. As you see, this slide shows how I made the green synthesis of zinc oxide nanoparticles. The method was optimized to obtain the best result because we first used a coffee machine but did not work. And then I boiled the blend sleeve to get the extract from them. So also I adjust the pH to make it like a mild, 6.5 to 7 in all the nanoparticles. If you want more detail about the methods, you can read my final thesis, please. So the synthesized zinc oxide nanoparticles was analyzed by using UV visible spectrophotometers to confirm the synthesis of zinc of nanoparticles. Then the scanning electronic microscopy was used to measure the size and identify the shape of nanoparticles. And finally, antibacterial activity was evaluated by using well diffusion methods in the first, this one, and spot blade method. we just, in the weld diffusion, we make a hole in the agar, while in the spot plate, we just a drop of the nanoparticles in the surface of agar. So the result tell us that the UV visible spectrophotometer confirmed that the zinc oxide nanoparticles successfully synthesized by using Tasmanian lanceolate and Kunzea ambigua leaf extract. You can see the difference, the different observation between the control zinc oxide nanoparticles and a green synthesized nanoparticles, Kunzea ambigua here, and Tasmanian lanceolate in the bottom. You can see it's a clear observation. So the scanning electronic microscopy shows that the control zinc oxide nanoparticles were flat in the shape. This one actually represents the best representative of the flat shape. And the average size actually was 220 nanometer, while in the Kunzea ambigua and Tasmanian lanceolate nanoparticles were multiform shape, and the average size was 120 to 170 nanometer. Now let's move to the antibacterial activity of the nanoparticles by weld diffusion method and spot plates method. You can see clear large zone of inhibition, especially against alpha biofilm stresses. In both methods, here spot weld diffusion, and here in the bottom spot plate method. And this is the zone of inhibition, alpha biofilm stresses A4 as a representer. Actually, in weld diffusion, we put in each well 100 micromil with the concentration of the nanoparticles 15 microgram per 0.1 milliliter. And the spot plate actually just only 10 micromil with the same concentration. So, yeah. This graph shows the mean of zones of inhibition of weld diffusion methods. The green synthesized zinc oxide nanoparticles show zones of inhibition against all tested bacteria. And the highest mean zones of inhibition were against alpha biofilm strains. The A4, where in the lowest zone of inhibition was against E. coli. Actually, this one is the nanoparticles, and this was the control. This one to the green one and the blue one is the extract, plant extract. We will talk that in the next point, slide. The green synthesized zinc oxide nanoparticles in the spot plates method also shows a highest mean zone of inhibition against alpha biofilm strains, but A9, and the lowest zone mean zone of inhibition were against Bacillus cereus. You can see the plant extract shows zone of inhibition against only alpha biofilm strains in both methods. You can see here, whereas in the E. coli and Bacillus, there is no zone of inhibition from the plant extract in both methods. Also, there is no significant differences between the mean of zones of inhibition of Tasmanian lanceolate nanoparticles and Kunzea ambigua nanoparticles antibacterial activities in both methods. You can see it here, and also in weld diffusion, there is no differences. Now let's discuss our result. The methods of synthesizing green synthesized synthesizing green nanoparticles, zinc oxide nanoparticles, was modified to obtain green synthesized nanoparticles that might hold high antibacterial properties by using a low temperature, 40 Celsius, particularly in the drying the nanoparticles to maintain the integrity of biochemicals that were extracted from the plant leaves. However, Other studies have used a high temperature which might affect on the active chemicals. Biosynthesizing zinc oxide nanoparticles using Tasmanian lancelate and Quinsia ambigua inhibited all tested bacteria greater than zinc oxide nanoparticles control and plant extract. We found that the Alphabriophilus transis strain were more sensitive for synthesizing zinc oxide nanoparticles than the plant extract. This might be because these marine bacteria have different growth requirement. For example, absolute requirement for sea salt that might help enhance the effect of nanoparticles, whereas it is not important for the E. coli and Bacillus cereus. Nanoparticles might be used as an alternative to antibiotic by adding the nanoparticles, for example, in this in fish feed as additives, as these bacteria multi-drug resistant. The bacteria may be established resistant against plant extract, but it is hard to resist the green synthesized nanoparticles. So let's conclude our, the conclusion, in the conclusion, nanoparticles is emerging as a new area of research worldwide, and nanoparticles can be used in many applications such as food packaging and food additives and food feed additives and food preservatives. It's clear that different bacteria have had a different response against nanoparticles, and more significantly, Alphabriophilus transis strain were sensitive to all nanoparticles. As a way to counter antibiotic resistant, nanoparticles can be potentially act as an antimicrobial activity. Future studies need to be test more plants to find better green synthesis nanoparticles. Also, more research need to be done in order to replace antibiotic antibiotic usage, especially in relation to toxicity. And finally, I would like to thank my supervisors, Prof. John Pohman and Sandra Garland. Also, I want to extend my thanks to Shane Powell, my unit coordinator. Also, the thanks for Zach, Caroline, Faisal, and Cameron. Thank you so much for your listening.